Rovers became the first ever Indian-owned Premier League club this week. Raul family completed their takeover, but they're here this afternoon.
Exciting times, good times to be involved at Blackburn, it would appear on the face of it.
Well, it would be on the face of it, yeah, and if it becomes a reality, then that would be obviously very, very exciting. You might lose your mind. I keep in my head down low through the summer. I'm out of my mind and falling over. I'm gonna take that time.
Blackburn have announced they've sacked manager Sam Allardyce. In a shock move, new owners the Venky Group have dispensed with the former Bolton boss's services, despite Rovers sitting relatively comfortably in 13th in the Barclays Premier League.
Yes, I would take it, and I would also respect if the owner said, well, we're going to bring somebody else in, would assist them, or would they're going to bring an assistant, or would a coach, you know, I would also be open to that, because, you know, it's a great club, I've enjoyed my time here, and I'd like to stay in some capacity. If that be the manager's job, then great. If it's another role, then I would definitely consider that as well.
Ewood Park is that Steve Kean has been appointed as manager of Blackburn until the end of the season. Gav Marcotti's only had one game in charge, hasn't he? He must have made a good impression in that 1-1 draw against West Ham.
Blackburn Rovers owners, the Venky's Group, have made a £6.2 million bid to AC Milan for Ronaldinho. Venky says it'll do whatever it takes to have the Brazilian superstar join David Dunn and the rest at Ewood Park.
First of all, we're trying to show, you know, a bit of intent that, you know, there's been two players linked with the club, David Beckham and Ronaldinho.
Yeah, that was pen was put to paper yesterday afternoon, so that was nice, and I'm delighted to sign that term and commit myself to the club.
Yeah, it's 5 cup finals for us, and you know, we're a little bit disappointed sometimes. You know, it hasn't been mentioned that, you know, before the Everton game we went on a little run. Okay, it was only 3 draws, but we feel as though that, you know, it was a little bit of momentum. We went and got a magnificent point at Arsenal. That wasn't really mentioned. We've only lost one game at home this calendar year, you know, which is almost 4 months. That's not really been mentioned.
Steve Kean took over on December the 13th. Blackburn were 13th on 21 points. But they've had a turbulent time under their new manager.
Cavalier for Blackburn. for Steve Kean.
I'm confident that I can take the club forward. I think it's going to be an exciting time for the club.
That's the Moja. Goes for the back corner. Finds it brilliantly.
Sure, we can get to the 40 points as quick as possible.
Blackburn remain in trouble. They still look nervously over their shoulders.
Tonight is his 17th game in charge, just three wins so far. Sam Allardyce had six in his previous 17.
Crop of young developing players, and she doesn't want to sell any of those players, wants to draw a line under that.
Huge transfer news then this lunchtime as Phil Jones has his medical with Manchester United. Tiger outside for a ride. What a
life. Blackburn jagt Raul. Die Blackburn Rovers haben offenbar ein Auge auf Schalkes Angreifer Raul geworfen.
Albeit only 1% of the fans that were in.
Steve Kean, 100% you're backing to produce those results?
101%.
We've been good against them on the club, so we've, you know, bring on the clubs.
Pressure is mounting on Blackburn manager Steve Kean after they dropped to the bottom of the Premier League after losing at home to Tottenham. The defeat to Tottenham was Kean's 15th defeat in 30 games in charge of Blackburn. He's only won six times and picked up just 27 out of a possible 90 points.
I don't know if it's a large section of the crowd, and to be fair, I'm not really paying any attention to anybody who's staying behind.